Hey YouTube, and by that I mean hey everybody in the world who uses Cubase and Reaktor. I spent hours trying to find how to do this. Finally figured out there's no way it tells you simply how to use it, how to do it. So here it is. So if you have Reaktor working as a standalone, you can play some funky bass lines in it with your MIDI keyboard controller. And yeah, I'm using vintage versions of Reaktor and Cubase because I like that retro feel. Or something. A lot of people seem to have problems with this. You know, you can open up Cubase, you can have other things from the same company working in there, like you can have Contact working fine in there as a VST, but you can't find the DLLs to add Reaktor as a VST in Cubase. So basically what you have to do is when you install it, and let me know if this doesn't work on other, if it works on other versions, but when you install it, by default, these things aren't necessarily checked when we get here. The top one and the bottom were checked. The middle three with VST included were not checked. So you just have to check those middle three things. I'm not going to uninstall it to show since this is working. I don't want to have it not working. But so the DLL, which is Reaktor5.dll, that's Reaktor number 5.dll, or in other versions, it's probably Reaktor version number.dll, is going to go into this folder. Should go in this folder, C, Program Files, Native Instruments, VST Plugins, 32, would go in 64 also. I'm using the 32-bit version of the Reaktor DLL, even though I have 64-bit Windows 10, because I have a 32-bit version of Cubase. Now, you're going to go in here in Cubase, vintage version, but let me know if it works on your version. You're going to go into Devices Plugin Information. And then pick VSTs, add the folder. It's already added here. I'm not going to take it out, but you'll add this folder, then hit OK. Hit both the update buttons, and then you'll see it in here. You have Reaktor in there. Now you can utilize it as a VST from within Cubase. So you go in, start a new instrument track, pick Reaktor, and pick your keyboard or whatever you're using to control MIDI with. Then click on the little keyboard icon to pick which synth or ensemble you're going to use and which preset or voice in Reaktor. Pick ensembles, and I'm going to pick synthesizers because I like synthesizers. There's some really cool ones in here. All right, so let's see what we got. And then you can start playing. And you can record. Then I'm going to pick the best one of those, or the second one, I'd say. And then quantize them. And I'm going to repeat it. And play it. And it's going to sound great. So that's how you do it, YouTube. It's my band, BipTunia, here. It's a one-man band, but it's pretty cool. It's all kinds of genres. All electronic, all MIDI, but with some singing. I don't quantize the singing, but if you want to help me out, go to BipTunia.com. And here's a trick. BipTunia.com goes to my SoundCloud page. I recommend getting your own URL and pointing it at wherever you have your audio. So if you ever get kicked off or if they go out of business or change their plan, you can, you know, people will know your URL, your custom name, and you can point it somewhere else. All right. Thanks a lot. Tell me in the comments if this helped you. Oh, and yeah, if you want to go to BipTunia.com and rate and review and tell two friends if you like my music, that would help me out for making this video. Thanks and take care.